Hey guys, welcome back to Embers and Ash. My name's Ashley, if you didn't know. And today I'm gonna be showing you what I fed my 6-month-old this week. So Monday morning, we started off very simple with just a banana. I don't really like putting effort into morning meals just because I hate cooking, so I only like doing it once a day for dinner. So I keep breakfasts very simple, either with something I don't have to cook or leftovers are key. So for this banana, I like to use this little cutter that puts little ridges in the banana, which makes it a lot easier for Rook to hold onto it, because bananas can be very slippery. And here's the man of the hour, chomping down on his bananas. Obviously nothing special here. He likes bananas, and we're gonna move on because this is one of the more boring meals. Oh yes, I also give Rook milk to drink after breakfast every morning. We give it to him in an open cup. This is specifically the Easy Peasy open cup. I really like this one because it's weighted on the bottom and it has little bump sensors so that he can get used to the feeling of drinking it himself. Every morning during the first feed, like breastfeed, I use my haka to collect some milk so that I can have it for this time of the day. And he's so used to it now, he gets really excited. It's still taking a little bit of practice, but he's getting the hang of it. And sometimes I only really use my hand to make sure that the cup doesn't fall, but he does most of the work. Like, he's learning to pour it back, but not too quick. Otherwise he'll choke a little bit. And it's all just a learning experience. I also wanted to include my cleanup routine because I've been trying to figure out the best way to do this with the least amount of effort. I used to just use wipes to clean him and the table, and I found that, you know, quite wasteful, and also he really doesn't like having his face wiped, which most babies don't like having their face wiped. So what I do is I take off his bib and I take him to the bathroom and I actually just wash his hands and his face in the sink like a normal person would. Some days he doesn't like this as much, but for the most part it's fine. I just rinse his hands one at a time with some soap and then I wipe off his face. I also am not super careful about like not getting water on his onesie because these are the pajamas that he slept in and I kind of just throw them in the wash after food is over. Even with bibs, it can get very messy, so I don't put any pressure on myself to keep it clean. And then we just dry our hands off and move on. As for the rest of the cleanup, I remove Rook's tray. This is the Stokey Trip Trap high chair, by the way. I really like it because it has a footrest, which is really important for baby-led weaning. And then I'm not really gonna explain the rest of this. I just literally wash his stuff. I try and do this right after the feed. Otherwise, I forget about it and I don't clean it until dinner, which is just annoying. So I try and do it right away. All right, dinner tonight is zucchini. And all I'm gonna be doing with this is cutting it up and throwing it in a double boiler. We got this double boiler as a part of our like wedding registry pot set. And I haven't used it once until now, like until having a baby, because it's so easy for making Rook's food. You just throw it in there, leave it steaming for a little while, and the food is good to go. I should also add that we do 5 new foods a week on weekdays. The first 4 days of the week are low risk foods, and then on Friday we do a high risk food, and we eat that food twice a day during the weekend to make sure there's no allergic reactions. So today the new food was zucchini. As with most new foods I give him, he's a little bit unsure and takes a while to warm up to it. But as you'll see coming up as we do leftovers, he does get used to the new flavors. And if he doesn't end up eating much, that's totally fine. I just control what food is put out and he controls how much he decides to eat. His main food source is still milk, so there's no pressure for him to finish his plate. Moving on to Tuesday morning, we got some leftover pancakes from the weekend. Like I said, leftovers are key for mornings. I also am one to not want to do dishes like a lot of people, so I will literally just use the lid of the container as a cutting board and also as the plate that I use to heat the food up in the microwave. I'm also adding the leftover zucchini. Babies need to be exposed to flavors multiple times before they'll like them, so of course we're gonna really rely on leftovers. I already know Rook loves pancakes, so it wasn't a surprise that he was chowing down on these. There's also Josh walking around. This is when Josh is getting ready for work, so he'll pop in and out of frame. And of course, again, we're doing our open cup drink of some breast milk. He's super freaking cute in this frame. Look at him holding it properly. He just kills me. He'll do this thing though where he's leaning forward to try and get closer to the milk, which obviously doesn't work with an open cup. So sometimes I have to remove the cup and start over. Sometimes I try and push him back a little bit. It's a learning curve. And then for dinner on Tuesday night was a mango. This is of course very simple food prep. You just cut it into slices and offer it up. We also threw some more zucchini on there, of course, because this boy needs more exposure to it. Also, if you're wondering, the plate that I'm using is the Avent plate, and I really like this one because it suctions down, and you can even put your fingers under the rubber lip and it won't lift. You have to pull it from the tab that's on the back end. Rook wasn't as instantly in love with the mango as I thought. I think just because it is more of a piney flavor. This mango wasn't super, super ripe, so it wasn't as sweet, but of course he still enjoyed it. Oh, I did realize though that I forgot to cut it with the ridge crinkle cutter, and so he was having a hard time holding it, so I just came in after and added some of those ridges with the larger pieces. And here we go, we're trying the zucchini again. Thankfully, he was starting to get a little bit more on board. This kid is so freaking cute. He'll put a strip of something in his mouth and suckle it like it's a boob. He just kills me. So this morning I actually do cook something, but it's very simple. I'm offering him some mushrooms today, which is his new food of the day. There are a lot of canned food options that are safe and healthy for your child. You just need to check the ingredients, like no salt added. You also want to make sure that things are low in sodium if there is natural sodium, and also low in sugar or no sugar preferably. So to prep these mushrooms, I just rinse them out of the brine that they're in. I don't really know if they were in a brine, but I just like to wash my canned foods. And then I went ahead and diced them pretty small because we're actually going to be turning these into an omelet, and I wanted to make sure that the pieces were small enough that they weren't choking hazards. I threw them in a bowl, then cracked an egg, whisked it up, and threw it in a pan. I also did add some oil to the pan first, which olive oil is really good for your baby. I definitely added too much here, but that's fine. As you can see here, there's a lot of oil in there. Rook has had eggs before, so there's no worry here, even though it is a potential allergen. And I was very confident that he would enjoy these because I know he likes eggs, and the mushrooms I think were just easily integrated into them. Something else that I'll do sometimes is I'll offer the new food first, and then a couple minutes in I'll add in a previous food just to make sure that Rook is trying that new flavor. So I did that here where I gave him some zucchini a little while into the meal, and you can really tell that he's starting to like zucchini, which is really exciting. Dinner tonight was a bit more complicated, but at the same time not at all, because I'm really just steaming vegetables again. This is also really easy to integrate into your own meals. So Josh and I were having asparagus, peppers, and steak that night. So I just took a couple sticks of asparagus and pieces of pepper and put them aside for Rook's meal specifically. All I did was I cut up the veggies a little bit and threw them in my double boiler and steamed them until they were soft. The asparagus is pretty much good to go once they're steamed, but the peppers, I don't know if you have to do this, but I like to take the skin off, which isn't an easy task. I haven't found a good way of doing it yet. It's pretty tricky. Rook has had asparagus and red peppers before, so I was very confident in this meal, but he wasn't as fond of the yellow peppers, which I didn't really expect. And breakfast this morning was just another round of leftovers. We got our asparagus, we got some peppers, and some leftover eggs from the day before. It's honestly so easy, and it's really what I need because I am just very lazy in the morning and I want to be able to feed myself and feed my son without thinking. So this morning, Rook was actually very moody, and that did not go well with mealtime. Usually Rook, if he's in a bad mood and I put him down to eat, he is so happy about it, but not today. So he didn't eat really any of his breakfast, which is totally fine because again, he doesn't need the food. It's just good practice for flavors and textures. So we just didn't eat breakfast this morning, and that's fine. So a couple hours later, we went back to the meal. He was in a way better mood and he did eat a good portion of his plate. So this evening I wanted to give Rook pork in the form of sausage. I found these sausage patties at the grocery store and they were like non-flavored kind of thing, so I thought they were gonna be great. Well, it turns out they weren't, and it was literally right before I served them to Rook that Josh brought up the point of checking the sodium content on the package, and it was through the roof. I don't know why this didn't cross my mind, so I didn't give them to Rook, and this really just goes to show that I'm learning at the same time as Rook is learning about baby-led weaning, and sometimes meals just don't work out, and that's fine. I was a little bit on a time crunch because I didn't want to push back Rook's bedtime too far, so I ended up just giving Rook what I had out, which was more banana. Not ideal because I wanted to give him a new flavor today, but that's just kind of how it goes sometimes. Friday morning. This is the day that we try those allergen foods, and today we were trying fish. Specifically sardines. So I did a little bit of my own research onto how to safely serve sardines. I got the package that is boneless and skinless, and it's the lowest sodium content that I could find. Yes, 140 milligrams is a lot of sodium, but I was only giving him one strip of sardines per serving, so that was really cut down in like fifths or something. And this is also really easy to serve because you just open it up and put it on a plate. As you can expect, this was an interesting one. So initially he was very interested and he didn't even put it in his mouth before he realized that it was weird. It's very fishy, it's a very strong odor and flavor, so I don't blame him for being hesitant, but he still gave it a little bit of a try. It wasn't much, that's for sure, and he ate mostly mango that morning, but he still gave it a try. Also, if you're wondering, sardines aren't really that bad. Like, they have a really bad reputation, but they're really just baby fish. And I tried it myself, and it just tastes like fish. It's a little extra fishy smelly, but it's just fish. It's not that big of a deal. And of course, we washed that fish down with some breast milk. Okay, so Friday evening, we are doing sardines again, but I wanted, again, some good contrast, so I thought, what better than some banana-flavored yogurt? Yogurt, again, is something that Rook has had before. We do the high-fat Greek yogurt, and I just mixed it up with some leftover banana. I thought that would be nice and tasty for him. And then I threw a huge chunk of fish on there. So of course, Rook loved the yogurt and banana. He seems a little kind of confused here, but let me assure you, he really was loving this. And of course, he was ignoring the fish that was in front of him. So I did my little trick of kind of presenting it to him to see if he would take it. And sure enough, he did. This is actually a pretty funny reaction. Because he already had yogurt in his mouth, it took him a second to actually get the flavor, even though he was sucking on it for a good few seconds. And he was very surprised with what he got. And he showed zero interest in taking a second bite. So what I thought of next was, well, what if I break up that fish a little bit and mix it with the yogurt so that it's not as strong, but he's still getting exposed to the flavor, which is a great idea in theory, but now I've put the fish in a sort of liquid form, which was not a good idea. That stuff got everywhere and it smelled so bad, like would not suggest serving fish in a liquid form, but it did really help him eat the fish in a less intense way. And I was gonna show you the meals over the weekend, but because we gave the sardines with every meal and didn't introduce any new foods, it got a little repetitive, so I'm just not gonna include it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and got some food inspiration for your 6-month-old. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye!